The business community says there's no need for a joint select committee on the Foreign Account Tax Compliance Act bill. The Trinidad and Tobago Chamber's CEO, Catherine Kumar, and AmCham CEO, Nirad Tiwari, are in agreement that both government and opposition must ensure the bill is passed. If not, they said, it would have a direct impact on all citizens. Their comments follow an inter-association conference to discuss the FATCA legislation. Melissa Dasraf tells us more.
The Chamber of Industry and Commerce CEO, Catherine Kumar, believes the government and opposition must work together in the Parliament to pass the legislation in order to meet the FATCA deadline.
There really is probably no need for a joint select committee because at this point in time, the bureaucracy in setting that up will take us way back. We will pass September the 30th, which is next week, Friday. So it can be done right there in Parliament by debating, agreeing on what amendments need to be made and completed, and have the bill passed. Sitting and hoping and waiting at this point, a mere week away from September the 30th, whether we would get any extension from the U.S. to me is just not on the cards.
Failure to do so could affect all citizens and cripple our country's long-term financial interests. That's according to Nirad Tiwari, the CEO of the American Chamber of Commerce of Trinidad and Tobago.
We are of the view that this is a politically manufactured crisis, and therefore the solution needs to be the creation of the space and the action to solve it. There is time. The needs or the amendments required to the bill are not extensive, and therefore they can be done on the floor.
And President of the Association of Trinidad and Tobago Insurance Companies, ATIC, James Camacho, said insurance claims would also be adversely affected.
But in particular, the insurance industry will be adversely affected by the withholding tax on investment income and also any remittances from reinsurance claims that may enter the country. So certainly, ATIC is certainly on board in terms of stressing the need for this important legislation to pass before next week, Friday.
Barbados, Jamaica, St. Kitts and Nevis, and Curaçao are just a few of the 9 Caribbean countries to have signed on to FATCA and passed the requisite laws. Non-compliance by Belize, further compounded by the Panama Papers, has stifled the banking services industry because U.S. banks have stopped doing business with them. Trinidad and Tobago must pass the bill or face sanctions imposed by the United States Internal Revenue Service. Melissa Dasroth for C News.